It's easy to see how literacy instruction fits within language arts, science, and social studies, but it's also vital in our math instruction. Check out this research. Students do anywhere from 10 to 30% worse on word problems than when the same problem is presented in mathematical form. Some of us hear that statistic and we think, I bet it's even higher than that. But regardless of the statistic, here's what the statistic means. They're not struggling with the math. They're struggling with the reading, the comprehension of the word problem. And for the sake of being specific, let's actually look at a word problem. Rachel is putting 177 CDs into new cases. She's already put 27 of those CDs into new cases. The CD cases come in packages of 25. Write an equation that can be used to determine the number of packages, P, Rachel still needs to purchase. Rachel has two options for purchasing the cases. Option one, purchase them from a website for $14.10 per package. There are 25 CD cases in each package. Or option two, purchase the CD cases at a store for 60 cents per case. Which option costs less? Use words, numbers, and/or symbols to support your answer. Do not include tax. Be sure to include the total cost of each option in your answer. If comprehension is what you're targeting, then you might have students read the word problem and explain the thinking, the thought process, step by step without solving it. That particular problem is a multi-step problem, and I want them to trace their thinking so that I can see what are they understanding, what are they interpreting, what are they reasoning in order. If we think of the math word problem as the reading voice, then this thinking, this write out and explain the steps becomes their thinking voice. Let me show you an example. Here's that same original word problem. I just tightened up the margins. And to the right, in red, that's the explanation without solving. Now, before I read that explanation in red, I want to point out two things. Number one, you are going to have to model this. A lot of times kids are doing mental math, or we're implying steps in our instruction, assuming students understand it. I want every mathematical thought explained. And the second thing I want to point out is the format of this strategy. You can't just give that original word problem in its very horizontal format. Where are kids going to write their explanation? I have to reformat it so I have vertical word problem and lots of space, blank space, for them to explain the steps to the right. So here's the thinking voice that I used when reading this word problem. Step one, Rachel's organizing CDs. She needs more cases and they come in packs of 25. I'm not making that up, I'm just pulling details from the original text. Step two, I thought she has 177 CDs and she's put 27 of those in cases already. Again, that's according to my reading voice, the details from the problem. Step three, write an equation to figure out how many packages she needs to buy. Okay, now, the write an equation is exactly what I'm supposed to do, so I'm telling myself that. But there are two other thoughts I'm having here in step three. I think as a math expert, equation means I need to have an equal sign. And I have to write out the equation. I'm not solving anything. I'm supposed to just write the equation. Then I think to myself, step four, well, I gotta figure out how many CDs she hasn't put in the cases, which means I'm gonna have to subtract 27 from 177. Now, note, nowhere in the word problem does it tell me to do that. This is an implied step that the student has to be thinking. That's what I love about this strategy, is that I can look back at the thoughts they're having and the thoughts they're not having and check that they're realizing what are some of the implied things you need to do to compute, to figure out before you can actually move on. After having that thought in step four, Step five. Okay, I'm going to have to divide how many CDs with no cases back here from step four by 25p. Again, I'm pulling that right from the word problem to determine how many packages she needs to buy. So again, to myself, I'm thinking of this equation, which actually will become what I eventually write here. Now, I've had all those thoughts so far, and we haven't even really got to the context, the bigger picture of the problem. The real question is this: what's the best deal? Should she buy all these new cases online or go to the store? Again, that's coming right from the word problem. So, using the specifics from option one, I think to myself, all right, it's $14.10 per package of 25. I figure out the cost by multiplying 14.10 by however many packages I needed. And didn't I figure that out? Yes, back in step five. But I can't figure out the best option if I don't think about both. So option two is, at the store, they're 60 cents each case. Figure out the cost by multiplying 0.6 by how many individual cases I needed. Again, that wasn't in the problem, but I thought about it and figured it out back in step four. My thinking continues, and I move on to the next step, and that is, now look at the total you got from step six and the total you got from step seven and compare them. Which one's the cheapest? And in my last step, step nine, I have to explain the best option, which is the cheapest, in sentences. By asking students to explain their thinking without solving, they are demonstrating, do they understand the big context, the big picture of this problem? It also illuminates what from the word problem they're misreading, misunderstanding, what from their thinking shows steps that are missing or omitted or out of order. Remember the research. It's a reading comprehension issue. It's a reading voice thinking voice issue. That's what I want to work on. And I don't want them doing math all the time. I want them to tell me what they're going to do and why they're going to do that, and eliminate the math for a short while. Thinking back to that research of up to 30% worse on math word problems, we know that math instruction is way more than memorizing formulas and equations and following patterns and procedures. We need to teach students some explicit math literacy skills as well.